When you find a family that has progressed to a place where things are so wrong, it might be that the thoughts, the right thoughts about family were not founded early. For those of us who are not married, and for those of us who are married, listen, take care of your family. That's one of your foremost assignments as a married man. Take care of your family. Take care of your family. I saw where Paul was speaking to Timothy and he said, look, if a man is not even able to take care of his own family, how can he even seek office in the house of God? If you're married, it is God, family, ministry. Because your family is your first ministry. Your family is your first congregation. As it were, if you're a pastor like myself, build that relationship now with your children. Build the relationship. As a matter of fact, if you want to influence them, be in their lives. You can't influence children in whose lives you don't function. You don't have a place. And I'm telling you, for every stage of their lives, there's how to get into them. Every stage. If your children like to talk with you, let them talk. If they like to play with you, respond. Respond and play. I encourage men and women, play with your children. Be part of their lives. Make that extra sacrifice to be in their lives. Now I'm telling you, if you lose them when they are young, you will seek for them with fear and trembling and may never find them ever. Yes, you will seek for them. That's why it's good to build a good relationship with your spouse, because the children will go. Oh yes. Yes, they will. They surely will. It's not even a prayer. They will. It will happen whether you pray or not. And when that time comes, that's not when you want to wander. So you've got to build your friendship with your husband. Build your friendship with your wife. Make it strong enough so that when the children have left, you still have a playmate, someone to play and talk with. I believe one of the worst experiences in the life of a man is to have nothing to talk about with his spouse. Nothing to talk about. You just wake up and look at yourself. Look. You gotta eat and sleep. Man, I play so hard that you have to beg me very hard to let you go. Oh yeah, that's the key. Hard play, strong play, until you blink your last blink and sleep. And sometimes I'll wake you up and play with you again, and you beg me half awake, half asleep, daddy please. But that's how to make it happen. Those little things matter a lot at this stage of life. Did you realize, maybe some of you can relate to this, that maybe you didn't have such a good relationship with your father, probably when you were younger, and as you grew older, you could find attempts of the man to just want to make you sit down with him or talk with him. In as much as you would want to, there was just no connection. I don't know if some of you have had that kind of experience. And at that time, they are desirous, wishing, hoping that you would just be there, that you would spend 30 minutes to sit. But you just want to run at every occasion, because that's how the foundation was. You remember those days when your father will come and you hear his horn from 400 meters away. Your blood pressure will rise. Then your heart begins to beat very fast. Looks like you're in some action movie or something. Then you run to bed and feign sleep, or you run to the toilet and sit there forever. Or you remember all your sins. You remember you broke a plate that day early. And your mom had told you, let your father come back. Don't worry. Let your father come back. And up appetite for your best food will leave you. So once you hear that horn, there are many voices in your head, you are dead. Wow. Hallelujah. You can build a relationship where your children are expecting the horn, where they are listening for every horn. Is that daddy? Is that mommy? And they're expecting you to come. Expecting you to come. Anxiously waiting with smiles. And for us, with salutes. Salutes. When my kids hear my horn, they line up just after the gate as I drive in. They are in salutes with big smiles. How do I respond? When I come close to where they are, I stop, wind down, and give a salute. That's how we do it. That's our culture. I don't know how we formed it, but that's how it is. There must be something that holds the family together. There should be a time when you can sit and talk with them. You can influence their lives. That's one powerful seed that you're sowing into their lives and into the next generation. However you see it, the children you have today are your vehicle into the next generation. It doesn't matter how much you achieve in your lifestyle. You have really achieved nothing if there isn't a transfer of values to those who will transport it to the next generation. So your success is not measured in isolation to what you have achieved as a person. Your success is intimately connected to how much you have transferred to your children so they can reproduce the same and more. Praise God. Take care of your family. Well, wisdom for love dealings. Just a few seemingly simple things that I believe can make a difference in our lives. And for people who are looking to get married soon, my number one is love someone whose character agrees with yours. Love someone whose character agrees with yours. I've seen too many relationship contradictions in this life. You know, the wise king said, look, there are many things I wonder about. And one of the things was the way of a man with a maid. You cannot rationally, logically look at the why between certain relationships. You just can't. Love someone whose character agrees with yours. Can we do a quick read from the book of Proverbs, chapter number 7? Proverbs 7. Hallelujah. By the way, how many of you are in a relationship planning to get married in this place? Let me see your hand. Don't deny him now. Ah! Okay, you want me to open your file? Okay, those pictures, can you... some people's eyes are shining now, like, does pastor have mine? You can never tell. Don't mess with me. I'm asking you for the last time. How many of you are in a relationship planning to get married sometime soon? Let me see your hand. One. There are some half-mast. So you're not even sure what you're doing. You're not sure. So all these pairs of people I see around town, I see consistent pairs of people. What's all that about? Are you business partners? Let me tell you, secret relationships breed sin. Basic principle, breed sin. Secret relationships will breed sin. I'm telling you. You know, we're taking it easy. We don't want people to know. We're not telling pastor yet. You understand, right? You know, why are you not telling pastor yet? Because you don't want to be accountable yet.